Guys and girls, here she is, the Super Duke, the KTM 1290 Super Duke R. I have not ridden this bike and I absolutely cannot wait to tell you guys what I think about it. So if you're interested in my first ride impressions, then definitely keep watching and I'll play the intro for you. Wow, gosh, I can't tell you guys how much I've been wanting to ride this bike. Oh, it's naughty. Let me tell you that for free, put your money away. Put your cash money away. She's zesty. Oh my god. Just all that torque. Sheesh. Okay, so this isn't the first time I've ever ridden a Super Duke. I originally rode, I want to say, the Gen 2 in about 2016. It was when the black colour, the all black colour, first came out. And I'll be honest with you guys, that wasn't really me test riding the bike. That was the bike test riding me to see if I was worthy of sitting on it. And let me tell you, back then I wasn't. The bike rode me. It took me for a ride on the country lanes and scared me a little bit, I won't lie. Now I've got almost 10 years under my belt since then, and you know, the bike's changed a lot. So how do I feel about riding it now? Don't get me wrong, it's still an animal. An absolute animal. But I feel more in control of it now. I feel like we're friends now. Woo! Good lord. Oh! No! Why? Oh, it's that torque. It is the torque. This bike has 140 newton meters of torque. Do you know how much torque that is in a naked bike? It really is scandalous to have that much torque. Oh, a cow! Disgusting! Right, and this has a standard exhaust on it as well. Standard. Oh! Gosh! You can get up to 60, so crazy. That's literally just second gear. It, oh, the power. This is one of them naked bikes that gets you tuned in, dialed in. It gets you switched on because it has that much torque available at your fingertips, literally. You don't even really have to twist the throttle and it's there. So I've got it in sport mode. Oh, I understand. I understand why people love the Super Duke. I get why Lily has one. I absolutely get it. It's preposterous. You don't need this much power. Oh man, it's naughty. It's so naughty. Like really, really, really naughty. It's exhilarating, guys. Second gear. It screams at you. Ah! But be good around here. Don't get carried away, Kate. Just because you've got all the power under the sun, and just because you've got enough torque to speed up the Earth's rotation by 3 times, you don't have to use it all. Oh, but woo, just the noise. Standard cam, standard exhaust. I can only imagine how obnoxious it would feel to ride this with like an Austin Racing or an Acura. Woo. 177 brake horsepower. Now, I know we're in the days of the 200 brake horsepower hypernakeds, but genuinely, I feel like when you have as much torque as this bike has, it's where you have all the fun. Blow down. Well, for me anyway. It's where I have all the fun. It's quite tall, 835 is the seat height. It's a little bit better now I've wound down the preload a bit, because it would proper set firm. Oh god, it just feels angry. It feels annoyed. It's like, do I have to deal with this woman? Well, yeah, you do. A bit of crap in the road here. Not great. Ballistic, ballistic. Absolute ballistic missile. Now this is equipped with a tech pack. So a tech pack is going to cost you... Sorry. Not sorry. Yeah, so this has got a tech pack on it, which will set you back close to £1,000. But the tech pack has everything. So the tech pack, it is worth getting, in my humble opinion. The tech pack comes with a track pack. Now the track pack has all the cool stuff on it, like the anti-wheelie, the different modes. It's got a performance mode, it's got the motor slip regulation, I think. It's just got a load of cool little bits on it, and it's got a track mode, of course. But the tech pack has then got the quick shifter and the auto blipper. Just got loads of stuff on it. Oh man, this bike. I really want one. I want one so much. Oh man, it's an animal. It's like 65 miles an hour feels like 120, purely because of how fast it can get you there. Like 140 newton meters of torque. That's something special, that amount is special on a naked roadster. We've got 75 degree V-twin. Oh. Oh. Woo! It is a maniac. It's a freaking maniac. Diabolical. Normally I'm a massive fan of the nadgery stuff. But admittedly, I like the nadgery stuff on something with a little less power. Maybe something like the 890R, because that's still got like ample amounts. Like, this has so much. I can imagine you could make a lot of big bikes, big sports bikes, cry on the big sweepers. Oh my. Excuse me, sir. Oh, look at these views. What a perfect.
little place to take that super duke car. Sladeburn. Summer has not been summering recently. It's been a big ass letdown, especially if you're in the UK, and especially if you're in the north of the UK. It's just been jokes. But we got a day today where the sun came out. A bit windy, but I'll take it for dry roads and happiness. But yeah, it's a lot of bike to handle. A lot of bike to handle. We've got exceptional brakes, exceptional. The suspension, although not electronically adjustable like on the Evo, which I don't have and I haven't ridden, I think it's like £1,500 more. I mean, we've got so much adjustability on this bike that I don't know. Do you need it? I feel like you have to be kind of rich to own a Super Duke. They're the vibes it gives me. Gotta be rich. Because KTM's, you know, it's expensive as it is. Then you want to put all the bits on it under the sun. Like, I've instantly spent £1,000 in my head on the tech pack. But then I'd want to do loads of things to its appearance, like probably sticky kits and just tart it up even more. I mean, those orange triple clamps scream my name, and I don't even own the bike. So what does that tell you? So yeah, I feel like you've got to have deep pockets. Oh, deep pockets are a must, I think. But if I was said rich person, oh man, this is a bike that I feel like me and Mike could get enjoyment out of in equal amounts. Probably a bit more for him because he's a bit more one wheel happy, but yeah, it's just Slade Burns this way. I almost just blindly followed that car in front. It's a sound as well. Like, I'm a real sound person. Sound is important to me, big time. It's got a sound. Spicy. Hello. Yeah, it's got to sound spicy for me. If it's sounding spicy, I'm halfway sold. But yeah, it's a freaking animal in terms of riding position. It is. It's got quite a stance to it. It puts you at a very aggressive riding position. Now, the reason I say that is because I've been behind Mike when he has ridden this bike. I've been behind Lily when she's ridden her bike because she has a Super Duke. And it really, really does make you look aggressive. I'll insert some clips here of Mike and Lily so that you guys can see what I mean, because obviously I don't have a camera following me right now. But in terms of what it feels when you're actually on it, you are a bit wristy. Like, not massively wristy, but just a bit. There are more aggressive position bikes out there, like I'd probably say the S1000R or the M1000R, because you have a proper flat bar on that, but it's still aggressive, I would say. Honestly, the instant acceleration on this bike is quite hard to put into words. I swear, KTM be tempting me with absolutely wild offers. They've got £3,000 off the Super Duke R and Evos at the minute. Which, wait, Quiblaw, Slaburn, yeah, Slaburn, go up here. Sorry, I just have to check the road signs because I'm not relying on my nav. But yeah, so these bikes retail at 17 grand or a penny shy of, no, sorry, a pound shy of $16,999. And then they're throwing in an extra, I think, 2 years warranty, so it's a total of 4 years warranty on the Super Duke. And I know people are sometimes nervous with KTMs, but I mean, I had a KTM for I think 3 years, 690, and I never had any, I didn't have a single issue with it. The only issue that I had with it was from a dealership, but other than that, the bike did not ever let me down. So from my own personal experience, I do have trust in KTM. But of course, you guys know that everyone's free to sound off in my comments section. I don't delete anything when it comes to feelings about motorcycles and stuff. I'll let you have your whinge on there, or I'll let you shine your praise on there for things. Now, this model's been, it's been around for like 3 years now, this third gen. So, makes you wonder, doesn't it? But yeah, I don't think you would ever be disappointed with this 1290 Super Duke car if anything else came out. How could you be disappointed? It's such a freaking badass motorcycle. Oh, I hope the microphone picks up that absolute howl. Oh, look, just look at this. This is freedom. Gotta be careful of the little sheeparoos and the turds. And gotta be careful not to get bent out of shape here and exceed my riding abilities, because there are lots of twists and turns and undulations. Is that the word? Did I just sound smart? Oh, look at this. Don't want another sheep gate on my hands, do I? Come on, lads. Off you pop. Wow. Oh, man. Oh, that cloud's looking ominous. Wow. Oh, look at this one. Look at this little booty shaking. Wicked, wicked, wicked girl, wicked girl. Yeah, you're not daft, are you? There are loads of little sheepy sheeps. Come on, Angel, off you pop. That's what they like. It's a very easy bike to ride, very smooth, you know. And I don't find it an issue at all riding through towns. I rode through a few towns to get here, and traffic was building because I've come out quite late in the day. Did some editing this morning, decided to come out and make the most of the sunshine because we don't get it for all that long in the UK. And through the town, even in sport mode, the mannerisms have been great. Little sheepy. I like riding big powerful bikes because you've got to show them respect. You have to respect them. They're the types of bikes that if you get a bit too big for your boots on them, they will chew you up and spit you out. Oh my goodness. Look. Look. Just look. Oh my days. Let's do a bit of a battery change here. Oh my gosh. Wow, wow, wow. This kind of riding is good for the soul. and you get to see lots of little friends on the way down. Hey friends! Stare me out. There'll only be one winner. It won't be you. Oh, just views. Views on views. Beep, beep, toot, toot, coming through, guys. Well, guys, I'm not really sure what else I have to tell you on this first impressions ride. Other than it's an absolute animal. I haven't quite experienced instant torque like it before. Quite addictive, makes me want to buy one, like real bad. Well, guys and girls, I hope you've enjoyed this vlog as much as I've enjoyed making it. Let me know what you guys think about the Super Duke in the comments below. Is it unnecessary? Is it just too much for the road? But would you still have one? Because I know the answer is going to be yes for most of you. Guys, if you haven't subscribed, please consider hitting that subscribe button. And until the next time, guys, take care and ride safe. Bye.